to the pockets and the salary and the foundation $4,000 dinners and the private club memberships and the first class.
Fuck you, Bono.
Air travel, though they have their own private jet, of course. What Bono did, this is a 1% compounded. There ain't no score for that. Tarski got 0.0 as a GPA, but Bono's more like Daniel D. Day or whatever. D. Day, all courses incomplete.
Mr. Matt's presentation is saying that the people who are calling for accountability about the billionaire class, he's saying that they may be waking up to the shenanigans. I'm not so sure if that's the case. In fact, I really don't see the relevance of that at all. Where's Mr. BBB? I do have something I do want to show. I thought this was amazing. There's a fucking dragon.
It looks like some sort of a winged creature flying in space. It's hard to even say. So, again, form your own conclusions. That's a video from the International Space Station of yet another object in the proximity, or at least in the field of view, of the ISS live feed.
What's
and
this
here recently,
shit?
We've been seeing this quite often, this type of activity, at least with
the
regard
thing's
to
got
white
wings.
Light. Not necessarily
fucking
objects
look at them
with
flapping.
Moving
look at that
parts
thing.
In the field of view of
the
ISS
fucking
live
dragon
feed.
In
and
space.
That clearly has moving parts. Whether they're wings or not, I don't know.
The
Let's
fucking
put it this
wings?
Way. Let me rephrase it. It has the personality of a bird.
It was fucking flying. What do you do when there's dragons in space flapping their wings, moving their things? What do? Fuck, you go in space and you want to look out there and you fucking see a space dragon? It's a bad motherfucker. He can fly in space. He's just going to land, going to come into the earth and just... I like shit like that. I actually love it. I've continued on this plasma shit. I think I tried to express my dream. When I woke up, all the things were lined up, all the gears. The dream that I had was about, see if I can show you the place. Let's see. I like to do visuals, but, you know, sometimes you gotta find different ways to do the same old shit. So... that's what I'll do here. Once I can find my Google. Hey, Google. Image of Hotel Galvez. Hey. I don't want to see the inside of the room. Okay, so this place. I don't know if it was this one. Anyway. So there's this hotel, and it's on the beach, except the one that, is that how we're doing it for real? So, except it's kind of curved, it had curves. There was different rooms, I think the floors were the timelines, and I've been in this same place before, because my brother has an apartment, and I walked through the wall to get there. The different floors are the different timelines. Then I listened to the Gigi talking about it. She's talking about different aliens and different interdimensional beings. Now, I've said before, and I'll say again, I have a whole story that I've wrote since I was 5. And I haven't put much out there. But the characters in the story, I think, represent these beings. Specifically, one that interacts with my character in the story is a manticore that's thrown out from his pride, which they're like lions. Manticores have human heads. They're like red lions. They have a tail with scorpion stingers. Now, I think this is some memories from Atlantis. I found enough strange evidence to suggest that I probably had some rebellion going on. Some of the Syrian rebellions. The names of these different groups on this thing that I was listening to that has a lot of Earth history from way back then. Because the aliens aren't You can't look at aliens like they're fucking coming from space. If they're interacting with you somehow, I've never interacted with an alien that I know. That I know of. I just don't know. Now, I did find some of this, sorry, find what I'm talking about. It's this. It's actually this one. The Secrets of Amenti. I'll just have a listen to this. This is pretty fascinating, actually. So I'm gonna play this and let you hear this.
From Anna Hayes, Voyager Volume 2. Secrets of Amenti. 1. Amenti 1. Guardian Alliance Gar equals 3D immense group of beings who reside in a myriad of locations in the time matrix. They are a member of the Interdimensional Association of Free Worlds. They are a member of the Interdimensional Association of Free Worlds, IAFW. AIFW members consist of biological below 70, etheric 79D, and light 10D15D beings. Administrators of IAFW and Gar are beings of pure immense metamass consciousness. Guardians of the Cosmic Matrix. Cosmic Matrix equals 3D Energy Matrix plus Time Matrix. Geomantic entities 16D and above reside in the Energy Matrix. These entities viewed from 3D would appear as geometric shapes made of living light. The four. Earth is Innu 1. Tara is Innu 2. Gaia is Innu 3. 560 million years ago, Project EURENUSI. 560 million years ago, Project EURENUSIAM1T1 begins. Many ET plus meta ETs created a master race to serve as guardians of planet Tara.
Master race.
Founders of Project T1 equals 3D Meta ET from U4 and U5 Lirans, U3 equals 3D Seed Race of T1 Syrian Council, U2 equals 3D Directors, Overseers of T1 Elohim, U3 equals 3D Race of Beings created by Lirans to oversee Syrian races in U2. T1 was made up of 12 subraces, genetics from 12 ET races. 12 subraces are Brahman, Drahman, Atoni, Trinitan.
Trinitan.
Azertan, Seltos, Adami, Utarans, Ceres, Nixacti, Melchi Stakes. Manipulation interbreeding by unrelated ET races caused major digression division. T1 split into two main strains. I, Alanians Belly Kudium. E, Lumians Adami Kudman. Alanians sought control over Lumenians, experimented with power generation through Tara's core. Lumenians asked for assistance from Syrian Council U2 and Elohim U3.
See, I've already had experiences that would suggest connection with some of these names. But the way that it comes into being entities and stuff, it plays into a story that I've already had since I was a little kid. Because I have a world, a map. And if I look at it, and if I turn it to a certain side, it looks like Earth just with the... It's really strange. So I think we come with all this knowledge, and then we wake up, and then we have to realize certain things. Now, obviously, I don't want to be a rebel of that type anymore. If I was one of these Alanians... I mean, that's one letter off from the name of the country. It's Alburania, and that one's Alania. Alburania, Alania. Just a BU. So what is BU? Beth Vav. So what is that? That's Beth is 2. 2 and 6 is 8. That's another number. So it would suggest that all of the clues are there if you just look and find them. to who you are while you're here. Now, I think there are Earth people, 3D repeaters, what they say, for Mr. Scott. And then there are the Wanderers. I think I'm a Wanderer. Just do. A lot of characteristics of an Indigo and a Wanderer. A lot of the Indigos came here. Their souls came here to bring the frequency up. But then listening to Gigi Young, and she talks about the way we overlay our home density over this place, and we have to relearn some of the basic dynamics of the 3D universe. One of which is that most of the universe that when we're looking out there, it's a simulation. Inky's got a cube around this space, and he's got this lower energy space. I feel that. I think that's going on. That's why there's 96% darkness missing, and they're looking for black matter, dark matter. Ain't gonna find no fucking dark matter. That other 96% is the actual universe we live in. We're in a dumbed-down perceptual boot, like the boot on the car, in this form. But we're here, so we're doing all of our different works and different shit we do to come into awareness of that. So the biggest one right now is you like my roly-poly? Try not to have this thing fall on my face. As I'm using this to comb out my really should get one of these. Highly advise it. Comb out your body. I was fucking feeling great yesterday. Got my flower of life. And then I rock and roll. Turn on my third eye so I can continue to. And I went in there and I worked on my dad. I put this on his. This is the. This foot, your right foot, is the inbound from the magnetic field charge off the earth where it comes into your body and it makes a circuit because you're part of the. It's you and the earth and all these other people that appear to be other selves, which are still aspects of you. I don't get in other people's heads, so I don't know what it's like to be them, but I've already committed to the path of, you know, don't hurt the other person is to hurt yourself, which is a big reason why I like doing this, peeling off people's faces, like Conan. You'll see Conan next. It allows me to identify and poke fun, and like I said, I like making collages. Not trying to steal anybody's work, trying to share the information as best as I can, because I think we are here on a mission to do something, and I do think the reality is, as Matt says, it gives itself away. It's so ridiculous, and I think that's just the byproduct of being in some sort of fucking container, being loose off of. Can you go to the bar? And they were talking about, you know, seeing these parasite worms going in and out of people, sucking their louche off. Because, you know, go to bars, there's a lot of that. I don't like going to bars. So, just saying.
Step. Free thoughts. Falcons at your wrist. And wind in your hair.
Wrong! Conan, what is best in life? To crush your enemies? See them driven before you, and they hear the lamentation of the women. That is good.
Well, you've got your diamond, and you've got your pretty clothes, and the chauffeur drives your car. You let everybody know, but don't play with me, 'cause you're playing with fire.